Good morning, everyone. So, our fourth lecture will start now. And in the last lecture, we have studied about the trigonometric ratios. Ratios for angle 30 degrees and 60 degrees. This we have studied in the last session. Let us continue the same. Now, the trigonometric ratios for angle 45 degrees. Angle 45 degrees. So, whereas while learning the ratios for 30 degrees and 60 degrees, we have taken an equilateral triangle. We consider an equilateral triangle. For finding the trigonometric ratios for 45 degrees, we are considering an isosceles right angle triangle. Here I am mentioning that isosceles right angle triangle. Isosceles right angle triangle means one angle is 90 degrees and remaining two angles are 45 degrees each other, in which the two sides AB and BC are equal in length. So, considering an isosceles right angle triangle ABC, in which here I wrote AB is equal to AC, the length of AB is equal to BC. So here length of AB is equal to BC we have taken, and the angle opposite to these two sides are angle 45 degrees and angle 45 degrees. Therefore, angle A is equal to angle C is equal to 45 degrees each other. Now, using Pythagoras theorem, in the last class only I said to you that Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. Therefore, here the hypotenuse is AC. AC square is equal to side AB square plus BC square. Here, we know the value of side AB as A units and BC as A units. We should have find AC. So, we are taking the formula AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So, AC square is equal to, what is the length of AB? A units. So, A square plus BC is also A units. So, it's A square. Therefore, AC square is equal to A square plus A square will become 2A square. So, that implies here AC square is there. We are finding the value of AC. If we are having square at the left hand side, if we taken towards the right hand side, will be square root. So, AC is equal to under root of 2A square, which is equal to root 2A. Therefore, the length of the side AC becomes root 2A. Now, using the trigonometric ratios definition, already in the first class we have studied the ratios definition. Let us take angle at 45 degrees. Sine 45 degrees. What is the formula or what is the definition for the sine? Sine is opposite side by hypotenuse. Here we are considered the angle at A, so that the side opposite to angle A is BC. So that I have taken BC by hypotenuse is AC. BC by AC, which is equal to A by root 2 A. AA get cancelled, we got 1 by root 2. At the same way, cos 45 degrees is equal to, what is the definition of cos? The definition of cos is adjacent side by hypotenuse. So here the adjacent side is AB. So AB by AC, that is equal to A by root 2 A. AA got cancelled, we got 1 by root 2. And tan 45 degrees, the definition of tan is opposite side by adjacent side. Here the opposite side is BC and adjacent side is AB. Therefore, BC by AB, which is equal to A by A, which is 1. And cot 45 degrees. Next is the definition of cot. Cot is nothing but adjacent side by opposite side. So, AB by AC. A by A, again we got 1. Next, second quadrupedal is, second definition is hypotenuse by adjacent side. So AC by AB, which is equals to AC value is root 2A and AB value is A. AA got the answer, finally we got root 2. Next is cosec 45 degrees. Cosec 45, what is the definition of cosec here? Hypotenuse by opposite side. The hypotenuse is root 2A and the opposite side is A. AA got the answer, finally we got root 2. So these are the trigonometric ratios for the angle 45 degrees. Once again, let us revise this. Here, while finding the trigonometric ratios for the angle 45 degrees, we are considering an isosceles right angle triangle in which the side AB is equal to side BC and the angle A is equal to angle C is equal to 45 degrees. Therefore, here we have taken that AB as A and BC as A. We should have find AC. For that purpose, we are using a Pythagoras theorem. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Here AC square is equal to A square plus A square. So AC square is equal to 2A square. Finally, we got as AC is equal to under root of 2A. Now we are using the trigonometric ratios definition. Here I am considering angle A as 45 degrees. So sin 45 degrees is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. So we got 1 by root 2. Cos 45, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Again we got 1 by root 2. Tan 45, opposite side by adjacent side. 1 we got. Cot 45, adjacent side by opposite side. So 1 we got. Sec 45, hypotenuse by adjacent side. So we got root 2. And cosec 45 is hypotenuse by opposite side. We got root 2. So these are the values for the trigonometric ratios for angle 45 degrees. Now let us go for the trigonometric ratios for angle 0 degrees and 90 degrees. 0 degrees and 90 degrees. So first of all, I will go through with the 0 degrees. For finding the trigonometric ratios for 0 degrees, here first of all, I am finding the trigonometric ratios for the angle 0 degrees. For this, what I am doing here? Here, a segment AC, a line segment. Line segment AC is making, a line segment AC is making some acute angle. Some acute angle theta. Some acute angle I have taken as theta. With the ray AB. Here I am considering that a line segment AC is making some acute angle with the ray AB. With the ray AB. So here that we know. And then this height of C is from BC. We are taken as BC. AC is a line segment we are taking, AB is a ray we are taking, and this is an acute angle, and the height of the C from B we are taking as BC. And then when this AC leans more, means the angle between the AB and AC, the angle between the AB and AC, if this angle is gets decreased, you see in this figure, this angle for the ABC, angle theta is gets decreased. So what happens if it is gets decreased, means the point of B, the point of B moves from B to B1. In the next step, B1 to B2. Why it is moving? Here the angle is gets decreased. Once again I am telling you that when AC leans more on AB, leans means the angle between the AB and AC is decreased. When the angle is gets decreased, the position of B will move from B to B1 and from B1 to B2. And finally, if total angle is gets decreased, the total angle is gets decreased like this,
If total aggregate gets depressed,
then what happens? This AC is completely leans on AB. So here I wrote, suppose a segment of length A is making an acute angle with ray AB. Height of the C is from B is BC. When AC leans more on AB, so that the angle made by it is decreases. Just know whatever I have explained, that only I wrote here. Then, as the angle A decreases, this angle A decreases, height of the C from AB ray decreases. Just know we observed in this figure. And foot B is moves from B to B1, B1 to B2. That also we discussed, no? That only I wrote in words here for easy understanding. And gradually when the angle between becomes zero, just now I said when AC is completely leans on AB, then the angle becomes zero. If the angle became zero, then what happens? Zero. Height will also becomes zero. The height BC, this AC is completely depends on AC is completely on AB, and B and C both are coincided each other. At that time, height is also zero. Height will also become zero, and adjacent side would be AC, that is equal to A. Adjacent side AC is A units. Now here the length of AB becomes AC because AC is completely leans on AB. So AB is equal to AC, which we are taking as A units. And the length of BC, the height of the BC is totally decreased. So this BC is zero. Here, therefore, we considered the angle at A. For that, sin A is equals to BC by AC. What is the value of BC here? Zero. So 0 by A, which becomes 0. Here I have mentioned A is equals to 0 degrees. Why A is equal to 0? Here what we consider, the line segment AC is making some acute angle with AB as theta, but when it leans more on AB, the angle becomes 0. That's why angle A is equal to 0 degrees. So next, cos A. Cos A is equals to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side and hypotenuse both are A. A by A becomes 1. Tan A. Tan A is nothing but opposite side by adjacent side, which is equals to 0 by A, which is 0. Cot A. Adjacent side by opposite side, A by 0. Something by 0 is not defined. That's why cot 0 value is undefined. Sec A is hypotenuse by adjacent side, which is A by A, 1. And cosec A, hypotenuse by opposite side, 0 by A. Sorry, is A by 0. A by 0 is undefined. Something by 0 is undefined. That's why that is 0. That is undefined. Once again, we will revise this trigonometric ratios for the angle 0 degrees. About the 90 degrees, we will see larger. And for the 0 degrees, suppose a line segment here, the line segment AC is making some acute angle theta with ray AB. When the angle gets decreases, the position of the B is moving from B to B1 and B1 to B2. When the angle is completely becomes 0, the line AC is coincides with AB. At that time, what happens? The length of AB is equals to length of AC is equals to A units, and the height is completely decreased to 0. That's why we have taken BC is equals to 0. So here we have used the ratios of the trigonometric ratio definition. Sin A is 0 by A, we got 0. Cos A, A by A, we got 1. Tan A, 0 by A, we got 0. Cot A by 0 is undefined. Something by 0 is not defined in mathematics. So undefined. Sec A by A, we got 1. Cosec A is AC by BC. So A by 0 is also undefined. So about the trigonometric ratios for the 90 degrees, we will see in the next class. Thank you.